The 13 on Your Side weather deck is brought to you by Montel Construction. Quality made simple.
Welcome back, West Michigan. I'm meteorologist Elena Neary outside on the kind of misty 13 on Your Side weather deck. We're starting to see that rain picking up across portions of our area after we did have a bit of a break, and we will continue to see more widespread rain and cooler conditions as we settle in to the next few hours. Let's take a look at our weather ball. It is blue. Cooler weather is in view. It's also blinking bright with additional light rain in sight. And this view sponsored by Countryside Greenhouse of Allendale. Overcast skies, quite the difference compared with yesterday when we had all that beautiful sunshine. Here's a live look from our Earth Cam overlooking the beach at St. Joseph. And we're seeing big waves on Lake Michigan as we continue to see those winds remain relatively breezy right at the lakeshore. But the farther inland you go, well, it gets a little bit less breezy. The winds are starting to die down, at least for the moment. But they will pick back up as we continue to usher in more widespread rain. Satellite and radar, and this is the regional view. We do have a patch of heavier rain just offshore from the Ludington area, and then lots more rain extending over into Iowa and portions of Illinois, also southern Wisconsin, and even a little bit of a wintry mix over here in the Great Plains region. And we're going to be seeing the potential for a few snowflakes as we move into the middle and end of this week. It's not going to be any accumulations, but just pay heed, take notice that we are going to be seeing cooler air that could support a few snowflakes arriving. So again, we'll focus first on the northwestern portion of our viewing area. Ludington seeing heavy rain. Also, Hart, and travel along US 10, you're going to be running into some pockets of lower visibility. As we move southward, we have a brief break right now, just a couple of sprinkles showing up in the Grand Rapids area, and I can attest, standing out here on the weather deck, just a few sprinkles, you probably don't even need the umbrella. As we get closer to the lakeshore, we do have that heavier rain starting to redevelop out over the lake. Eventually, that is going to move inland. Break for now, Kalamazoo, Battle Creek, but a couple of sprinkles in the southern side of Kalamazoo County. So areas along and south of I-94, you could be running into some wet pavement. Here's a big picture. Again, we do have that cluster of the pockets of heavier rain to the north, and then some offshore showers beginning to approach the areas like Ottawa County and moving into western Kent County as well. As I come back out here at around the 12:30 mark for this hour newscast, I'll probably need the umbrella at that point. Hour by hour, we will see additional stronger winds coming up out of the south and southwest. More widespread rain for the rest of tonight. We could see rainfall accumulations on the order of half an inch. So watch out for some low-lying flooding in isolated areas. Here's a look ahead, the 13 on Your Side forecast. And here comes that cooler air. Morning showers depart. We'll see sunshine by Tuesday afternoon, and then we could see a slight chance for a wintry mix as we move into our Wednesday. We surge back into the mid-50s with the chance for some scattered showers late on Thursday. It's kind of a roller coaster as far as the daytime highs are concerned. Average temps for this time of year, 41 degrees. We'll be right around that as we move into the weekend with dry conditions anticipated Saturday and Sunday.